Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Solution. Today I am going to start the most hot topic, that is Flask. So without wasting our time, let's begin with the Flask project. I am getting multiple requests from the techies, okay, why you are not starting the Flask project. Flask nowadays is boom on the markets. Then I decided, okay, let's start the Flask project. So what is Flask? Flask is a web application framework written in Python. Armin Roncher, who leads an international group of Python named Poco, develops it. Flask is based on WaskJKub, WSGI toolkit, and Jinja2 template engine. Both are Poco project. Then who is audience? This tutorial has been prepared for anyone who has a basic knowledge of Python and has an urge to develop a website. After completing this tutorial, you will find yourself at a moderate level of expertise in developing a website using Flask. Okay, so what is web framework? Web application framework, or simply web framework, represent a collection of libraries and modules that enable a web application developer to write application without having to bother about low-level details such as protocol, threat management, etc. Okay, what is Flask? Flask is web application framework written in Python. It is developed by Armin Roncher, who leads an international group of Python named Poco. Flask is based on the WaskJKub, WSGI toolkit, and Jinja2 template engine. Both are Poco projects. Okay. What is WSGI? WSGI, the full form of WSGI, Web Server Gateway Interface. That is Web Server Gateway Interface. WSGI has been adopted as a standard for Python web application development. WSGI is a specification for a universal interface between the web server and the web application. Basically, it is trying to connect with the HTML file that is going to the web server, web application, and going to connect with the server. Okay, that is WSGI, Web Server Gateway Interface. WaskJKub. It is a WSGI toolkit which implements request, response objects, and other utility functions. This enables building a web framework on top of it. The Flask framework uses WaskJKub as one of its bases. What is Jinja2? Jinja2 is popular template engine for Python. The web template system combines a template with a certain data source to render dynamic web pages. Flask is often referred to as micro framework. It aims to keep the core of an application simple yet extensible. So, prerequisite, we are going to use Python. Now I am going to remove a prerequisite. Python 2.6 or higher is usually required for installation of Flask. Python 2.6 or above. Flask and its dependency will work with Python 3 also. You can use Python 3.0 or above also. Now I am going to install virtual environment for development. So virtual environment is a virtual Python environment builder. It helps a user to create multiple Python environment side by side. Thereby, it can avoid compatibility issue between the different version of the library. Now I am going to install virtual environment. Let's go to the Python terminal. Okay. Okay, this is that I am going to write in the command pip 3 virtual pip 3 install virtual env enter. Now I am going to create virtual environment. For that I am going to type virtual env space env. Okay, after enter this command you will find one environment folder that is going to create here. Okay, let's enter. Okay, now you can see the one environment folder include lib and script. Now I'm going to activate this. For that what I'm going to do, I'm going to use env backslash scripts slash activate dot batch and enter. Now you can see the env here. Now that means this environment is active. Now whatever I'm going to write the type the command, that is going to work only this environment. Okay, this is clear. Now I'm going to install Flask. For that I'm going to use pip 3 install Flask enter. Now the Flask install. Now you can import the Flask. Here import Flask, and if you are going to run this one you will not get any error, right? That means your Flask install in your environment. Now I'm going to run the Flask. Okay, Flask web application. For that I'm going to import the Flask from Flask import Flask app equal to Flask underscore name underscore, that is Flask name, and that is after that I'm going to give the root app dot root and then going to backslash, and I'm going to define hello world. Then hello world, welcome to Flask. Okay, name equal to underscore main, then app dot run. Okay, now what we are doing here, we are importing the Flask module in this project. It is mandatory to import Flask module. Okay, now this is Flask constructor that take the name of current module, that is underscore name. Okay, and this is the root function. What the root function will do, the root function of the Flask is a decorator. We tell the application which URL should call the associate function. Okay, now for that basically we have app dot root, and that is the rule, one of the parameter, and another parameter that is option. Okay, the rule parameter represent URL binding with the function, just like when you're going to run this application, then after running that what it will call, it will call backslash only. Now if you want to specify particular name, then you're going to specify backslash name. Okay, I will show you this example also. An option is basically the list of the parameter to be forwarded to the underlying rule object. In this above, basically backslash URL is basically bound with the hello world function, right? When the
When the home page of web server is open in the browser, the output of this function hello world welcome to Flask that is going to render. Finally, this is the run method of the Flask that runs the application of the local development server. Okay, now I'm going to tell you what the parameter app.run. We have the four parameter. One is the host that you can pass, second is the port, third one is debug also you can do, and options also you can use it. Okay, host name is a listen on, that is default is 127.0.0.1. okay, port is default is 5000. Okay, and port is default 5000. Okay, debug is default to false. The third one debug is default to false. You can true also when you want to debug. Options that is to be forwarded to underline WakeJugo server. Okay, now I'm going to run this application. Let's run this one. Right, you will see that 127.0.0.1 and the port number is by default 5. Now I'm going to clear and you will see hello world is welcome to Flask is going to print. Right, this is clear. Now I am going to debug mode. What is the debug mode? A Flask application is started by calling this run method app.run. Right, however, while the application is under development, it should be restarted manually for each change in the code. To avoid this inconvenience, enable debug support. The server will then reload itself with the code changes. It will also provide a useful debugger to track the errors, if any, in the application. The debug mode is enabled by setting the debug property of the application object to true before running or passing the debug parameter to the run methods. Right, now I'm going to set debug mode equal to true. Right, now what will happen if I'm going to change anything here, then it's going to reflect immediately without going to rerun once again. Now I'm going to run this one. Right, starting with the stack debug pin. Okay, and this one I'm going to copy here and run. Right, hello world, welcome to Flask. Now if I'm going to change something here, name, right, and save, then if you are going to run this one, this will give the error, not found. Right, but again if I'm going to use backslash name, then it will work fine. Right, hello world, welcome to Flask, because we are going to root this backslash name. Now if you're going to remove this one, app debug, if you're going to remove this one, right, then what will happen? Now we have to stop this one, okay, and reruns once again. I'll tell you what the difference. I'm going to refresh this one. Name is there, okay, name is there. Enter. Right, now I'm saying hello world, welcome to Flask. Now if I'm going to remove this name and save it, right, now if I'm going to run this one, right, it will not affect anything. Now if I'm going to affect this one, right, whatever the changes we are doing here, right, it's not going to reflect. When it will reflect? When we are going to stop this one and reruns once again, then this will work fine again. Now if you are going to run, then it will say welcome, hello world, welcome to Flask. Now I'm going to stop this one, and now I'm going to use debug equal to true. Then what will happen if I'm going to do, now I'm going to run this one. Right, going to refresh this one, right, and then you say hello world, welcome to Flask. Now I'm going to change with name and save it. What will happen if I'm going to refresh this one? Then what will happen? Pause for a second and think once again. It will give the error, right, not found, the request URL was not found. Now if you are going to use backslash name, then what will happen? It will give you hello world, welcome to Flutter. When we are using debug is equal to true, then any change if you are going to do here in the Python file, you don't have to stop this one. It will reflect automatically because we are using debug equal to true. And when you are going to remove this one, debug equal to true, and then if you are going to change anything in this Python file and we are going to reference, then it will not work. We have to stop this one and rerun once again to reflect the changes of the Python file. Okay, this is clear now. Now what is routing? Modern web framework use the routing technique to help a user remember application URL, right? Just like a backslash name, backslash that's name something, and that is obviously not going to use, but just like a host, just like a server name, that when you're going to use backslash server, right? Backslash host kind of thing. Then root, then it is useful to access the desired page directly without having to navigate from the home page. The root decorator is flash used to bind URL to a function, just like we are binding here to the hello worlds, right? Now same things, if you are going to use instead of name, now I'm going to use hello, right? The hello URL basically is root is bound to the hello world function, right? It's easy to remember. As a result, if the user visits localhost colon 5000 backslash hello, like this, if the user is going to use http localhost colon 5000 backslash was the root hello, right, then it's going to return, it is going to bound with this hello world functions and it is going to return the hello world welcome to Flask. Okay, what the output will be, that is going to render this hello world functions will be rendered in the browsers. Okay, now we can use add URL rule function. Now I'm going to show add underscore URL underscore rule function. What add underscore URL underscore rule function will do, it basically of an the add URL function of an application object is also available to bind a URL with a function hello world. Okay, that is route is going to use. Now what I am going to show you, add underscore URL underscore app dot add underscore URL underscore rule backslash comma hello, and this is going to hello world. Okay, now this is going to bind with this one. I'm going to comment this one. Now I'm going to use this URL. We will get the same output when you are going to type this localhost colon 5000 backslash hello. Okay, this hello world is going to bind with this function. Okay, let's try and see. Debug mode on, restarting with the server active. I will show you what the use of debugger pin also. To reflect this one, I'm going to refresh this one. You will get the same output, right? Hello world, welcome to Flask, right? This what he will do is going to add the URL rule, and this is basically hello world, nothing is going to bind with this function, right? This is clear now. So what is the variable name? Flask variable rule. Now I'm going to show you what is. I'm going to remove this one. Let's remove this one. Flask variable rules. Okay. It is possible to build a URL dynamically by adding a variable parts to the rule parameter. This variable part is marked as a variable name. Okay. Now we are going to add the variable name also to the URL. Okay. It is passed as a keyword argument to the function with which the rule is associates. Now I am going to show the example. The rule parameter of the root decorator contains name variable part attached to the URL hello. Right, I will show you. Now in the previous example I show you, right, backslash name kind of thing, right? This is we are doing hard coded, right? Now what we will do, we are going to pass instead of name, we can pass anything here as a variable, and if you are going to type this like instead of backslash name, whatever you are going to type in the root, that is going to reflect into your functions. Okay, now I'm going to define the root app.root, and we are going to pass backslash hello backslash name. Okay, and after that now I'm going to define the function hello underscore name. We are going to pass this name and we are going to return hello percent as column, after that percent name. Okay, that is found with this name with this one. Okay, now whatever the name is there, that should be the same. Okay, because this name is going to bind with this one. Okay, now after that, if double underscore name underscore equal to single equal to name. Okay, and we are going to app dot run debug equal to 2. Okay, now I'm going to run this one. Stop. Refresh this one, it will say not found, no problem. Now I'm going to add backslash name. What is there? Sorry, hello, right? This one is hello, right? Backslash hello backslash text solution. Then what will happen? What it hello text solution. Okay, let's enter it, right? Hello text solution. If you're going to change something here, hello flask project, then what will happen? It will print hello flask projects, right? This is clear now. Now I'm going to show you, in addition to default string variable part, that rule can be constructed with the following converter. You can use integer as accept integer, float you can use floating point values, and path accept slashes user directory separator character. Now I'm going to show one by one, integer as a path vector, float integer, float and path. Okay, let's remove this one, float and path, and stop this one. Now I'm going to use app dot root and going to use blog backslash integer backslash column and post ID, and we are going to close this one. I'm going to create one function, show blog, and going to use post ID. Okay, whatever there we are going to pass in the root, same we are going to use it here also. Okay, and return blog number percent d in percent post ID. Okay, now I'm going to show you float also, define. Okay, before that we are going to use root app dot root and backslash rev float revision number. Now I'm going to define one function revision. We are passing revision number colon, going to return revision number percentage F and then percent revision number. Okay, now I'm going to if name underscore underscore equal so underscore main colon and app dot run debug equal to true. Okay, this is clear now. Now I am going to run the error code. Okay, let's run and see what will the output. What is saying? The converter integer doesn't exist. Okay, we have to use small I. Okay, let's run once again. What is saying? URL name, this should be close. Okay. Let's run once again. Okay, restarting with start 1124. Then it will print block number 1124. Now 112411. Then it will print 1124111. 45. Enter. Then it will print 112411. Whatever we are going to pass it here, it is going to print, right? The integer is now is fine. Now we log. Now we are going to use rev / float value, just like a 1.1. Then what is going to print? Revision number 1.1. Okay, enter, right? Revision number 1.1. 1.190, then it will print 1.190. 1.190, 1.2.3, then it will print 1.90, 1.2.3. This is clear now. Now I am going to show third one, root. The URL rules of Flask are based on WorkJux routing models. This ensures that URL format are unique and based on the precedent laid down by Apache. Right? Now I'm going to show you the root, the third one. For that I'm going to use third one root path, right? For that I'm going to remove this one. Now I'm going to get path app.root. For that I'm going to use the 7jump flask. Okay, and then after that I'm going to call them return. I'm going to create one function, flask hello flask. I'm going to return hello flask. Now I'm going to create one more root, that is basically is Python. Okay. Now I'm going to pass return. Now I'm going to create one function, define hello Python. Okay. And that will return your hello. Hello Python. Okay. Now I'm going to stop and rerun once again. Then what will happen? Now if I'm going to with /flask, then it will be hello flask. And then if I'm going to use /python, then it's going to print hello Python. Okay. Now I'm going to remove this one flask. Then it will be hello flask. I'm going to print hello flask. Now if I'm going to use hello Python, then we have to pass the Python, then it will print hello Python. Okay, this is clear now.